In this video, I will cover the RAAS, or Renin Angiotensin Aldosterone System. The RAAS is an important regulator of blood pressure. Here's how it works. There is an important structure in the nephron in the kidney called the juxtaglomerular apparatus, which contains cells, juxtaglomerular cells, that secrete an enzyme called renin. Renin is secreted in the blood in response to low blood pressure in the renal artery, as well as activation of the sympathetic nervous system and decreased sodium in the kidney tubules. Renin combines with angiotensinogen, which is secreted by the liver, which results in the formation of angiotensin 1. Angiotensin 1 travels in the blood and combines with the angiotensin-converting enzyme, ACE, located in the blood vessels of the lungs. This results in the formation of angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 has a variety of actions, which include vasoconstriction, increased sodium retention by the kidneys, release of aldosterone by the adrenal cortex, release of antidiuretic hormone by the posterior pituitary gland, stimulation of thirst centers in the hypothalamus, and increased release of sympathetic neurotransmitters such as norepinephrine. Aldosterone promotes sodium retention in the kidney tubules. Water is also retained by way of osmosis in an effort to conserve fluid volume. All of these actions work to increase blood pressure. For example, water retention from aldosterone and antidiuretic hormone increases fluid volume, which increases blood pressure. Vasoconstriction increases peripheral resistance, which also increases blood pressure. Medications for treating hypertension work to alter this pathway. For example, ACE inhibitors decrease the formation of angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 blockers decrease the effects of angiotensin 2, and aldosterone receptor blockers decrease the sodium and water retention effects of aldosterone. I sincerely hope that you have learned something about the RAAS system. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.